everybody, so today I would like to show you something that I've been working on, and it's basically multi-purpose backup loadouts in a sense, where I'm trying to go away from the unusuals to like blend more in a normal game, to not be focused as an example, or no, in the future it would be good like aliasing with it, I don't know. You know, multi-purpose can be a lot of things, like can make games where I basically show how it looks like when I play without unusuals, and even though I prefer still using my weapons with this, I just put this up like as an example of what could be used instead of the unusual weapons. Another thing is that I do want to build it around my strange cosmetic slot here, because then I would lose stats that didn't track in that sense. Some of you may be quick and notice, wait, isn't your sniper unusual hat unusual strange? And to that, yes. But I have something in mind for that I'm gonna show you guys. It's not like that spectacular as probably getting a strange normal one and then switch stats whenever I need it. Nah, it's not nothing like that, but it's some little smart trick I can do with the effect that it have. And then this is just what I went for here as like to show. Would probably go with the Mad Milk because this is pretty heartless combo, even though the Mad Milk doesn't really work that well with the Force of Nature. But hey, just for show, let's move on to the Soldier. So also a pretty nasty loadout where you basically have the Ubercharge function for Soldier, even though it's a bit of a worse Ubercharge, but it's team-wide and you have different ones. But I thought this would synergize best with what I'm going for here. Since this have a bit of a, you know, self-damage down from rocket jumps, I don't really need the gunboats, and then I run this instead. Not really the base jumper, even though it would give me a lot of firing speed, but the idea is basically to have a better rocket launcher with like more clip in it, and then be on the ground basically, and then have the healing, and then escape plan if everything goes bad, and then for like cosmetics, just going with something standard, you know, the team captain and then some nicer pants instead of like the military boots and whatnot. I thought this looked a bit more simple. With pyro, I kind of wanted to, you know, this is probably what I would be using, but for the purpose of show, it's the same with like the Criticola where I would probably use my pistol or Mad Milk instead, but for show, just this, because then it would be degreaser and, you know, basically pretty standard, and then to not blend out too much, pretty standard as well, and then still have the strange cosmetic. So that's pretty simple. About the demo, man, I had a bit of a problem here because, I don't know, stock is just so good, but I figured I don't really use these two that much. I made one episode with this, which is why this even has stats, and I have tested this out a bit, like 4 kills, I guess. So this is what I thought about here, and then, you know, go with the middle age style here, where I then took the cape, even though it prevents the base jumper, but then I could always get like soul saviors, like the middle age, I don't know. Anyways, get some, you know, the metal boots, basically knight boots. But then it wouldn't consist with demonite, but then I would be able to use this with demonite, basically, is what I've been thinking there. Of course, this load I wouldn't go if you go with base jumper and boots for like more HP and then go for your melee kills. But I don't think I'm the guy to go with that anyways. I need something more powerful. Usually I'm supposed to, you know, be the best on my team because I... some other people who aren't contributing who does this shit, and then, you know, gotta try and win at least, unless we are doing a troll video, which we could, and then I just feel like this would go very well with it, so there's nothing much there. Let's just move on to the heavy. For the heavy, I thought, yeah, the team captain pretty standard would look good. It's the same with the soldier, plus I can switch to my unusual team captain if I need, just for like show. And the bedroom warmer, I've always liked this, and I'm actually surprised to figure out that these are compatible, because I thought this would cover up the, you know, shirt slot, I don't know, it apparently doesn't really cover anything up, so I can combine it with the bedroom warmer, and then the idea would be to get a strange, but now that it's multi-class, I don't really like it that much, but hey, now I can use it for this kind of loadout and still have it, so I really like that thing. And for here, basically the thing is, like, you have the sandwich healing in case, and then you have assassination, where, like, the 7-0 spin-up sound, so you can be around the corner and wait for people to walk past you. And then you also have these gloves, because you don't really care about speed here, you just care about hitting people in the back and then force the taunt kills. That's at least the idea I had in mind here. Then for engineer, like, I have this where it's basically, you know, my version of stock NG. But then this, which I assume a lot of people have seen. The fun thing is, I've given these away several times in a sense, as in other versions, and then I've rebought them. And, I mean, it's a good thing that I've rebought them, and then I also recently repainted this. Actually, this wasn't bought, this was crafted in one of my episodes, and then I gave another one away instead, because I kind of wanted one crafted by myself. But you may also notice, yes, I have the pistol on here, even though that's something I would go away from, but the pistol just fits so good, and it is kind of my signature weapon. So if it should be used in somebody, why not the engineer? And then either gunslinger or jack, and for weapon it could be with Omega, Frontier Justice, or Stark or some shit, I don't know. Even panic attack, like the options are open, but this would be like the standard for show kind of thing. With Medic, I've decided to also go with the team captain, and then why not Archimedes, you know, his bird. And then going for a bit more of a combat Medic style here. Like, of course it can be adapted. Could go Quick Fix or Vaccinator, but hey. And then just the pan, so I can, you know, basically this is meant for combat Medic, I don't know. Doesn't necessarily need to be, can easily swap in, like, other things like the Ubersaw and as set up their crossbow, but just something a bit more simple basically. For the sniper, and this is where I have something in mind specifically, for the primary I would be probably using the, like, either the AVP, because I do have that, or the Machina. And then Razorback, because that'll probably bait some spies in, I'll be able to hear it and then pan them. And then with this, the thing is, if you adjust effects like these orbiting ones, they just vanish. They aren't, like, here you see them. In game you may see them, but they're basically not on your character. Enemies can't see them. And that's like the thing that would hide my sniper here. Plus I do like the, like, I like this, like, kind of combo here with the Snowscope and Triggerman's Tacticals. So it would just basically look like a normal anger, a Snowscope and, or, yeah, Scope and Triggerman's Tacticals when this is adjusted. So that's kind of what I thought for sniper there. And then with spy, this is probably gonna, like, it's pretty predictable. Pretty much the same, just this on. Like, the fun thing I could do with spy is that I could just go, you know, the, like this as an example, because I do have this. Because spy is almost disguised all the time anyways, especially with this kind of playstyle. And it doesn't really matter if I have unusual effects or not. And with that, the same mindset was with the weapons. So that's what I thought there. But for the sake of this, I just went with these things here. Like the dashing that I usually have. And then, you know, this is what I used before I, like, got an unusual for him. So, pretty good. Like, before I decided to buy all of these other things that I've purchased for this, I had the thing, like the option of going without unusual hats on my spy and my engineer, but I couldn't really do that on any of my other classes. I didn't have the cosmetics, so that's also why I got this idea. You may also have noticed, like, the texture is pretty messed up here, and even on, like, the little preview window. That's because recently, and I thought this was something with, like, I don't know, my computer maybe, I don't know, but when I've been streaming and whatnot, and I switch weapon, the game sometimes, like, lagged, basically like cogwheels grinding into each other, and, like, basically freezes for a bit of time every time I switch, because it'd have to reload the weapon. And by what I can gather from what I've read, a lot of people seem to have this issue, and it's with all skinned weapon, not even unusual weapons. But going down to, like, medium textures, which is, let me see, right here, like texture detail medium, then problem's gone. It doesn't lag anymore. If it's high or very high, it does, even though the weapons look sweet. So I would like to run these, but just doesn't seem to work with the game right now. I think that covers it. Like, you've seen all my, I guess you you could call it like multi-purpose loadouts, I think I'd call it. And hope you guys enjoyed the creativity I've put into this and like thought I've put into this. And hope to see you again next time.